Hey folks, welcome to round three. We are going to be on the play. Well, no matter how good Coffin Queen is, I don't think we can keep six mana sources Coffin Queen. If the Dark Ritual was a removal spell, I'd probably keep. Sure. We have our best threat. We have an edict. We have something to get our best threat back. Should be fine. Keep this. We're in good position to edict him at end of turn, whatever he plays. Boros A. Yeah, I would like to kill that. Not something I'm looking to reanimate, though. So hopefully we draw a 3-drop. Nope. But that's fine. So many stalking stones. That one's not foil, too. Comes tougher when it attacks. Sure. I'll play Shade for now. Playing the warrior would be okay too, because then he has to like get it out of the way before he can attack with the charging paladin. But I think this is a little bit better. If we hit our land drop next turn, we can play warrior, double pump, hit him for 3. Go down to 15 ourselves. One 4 with vigilance. That looks pretty good against the Serpentine Warrior. Maybe I'm just supposed to Dothy Horror in 3M. Nah, Dothy Horror doesn't stop this thing from attacking. It certainly doesn't stop the stones. Maybe I'm just supposed to pump this to 5 and just put him on a 4 turn clock. Like, if I 5 him, and then he attacks me back for 3 down to the 15 that I'm at right now, and he'd be at 15, then I 5 him again down to 10, and he can 3 me again down to 12, 5 him down to 5, I'm at 12, and okay, oh, he has shackles anyway. Pretty glad I didn't go all in on him then. Plays a Pegasus, no problem. We have a Sliver and a Dothy Horror. Do we want to play both of these? Is this Sliver relevant? Is it even, like, quasi-relevant? It's hard to tell. Oh, we could bring in that Rats against Shackles. The Rats where you, like, destroy your own permanent. I don't think we took it, though. But it'd be an interesting answer to this, because we could destroy it and then, like, Death's Duel it back to our hand or something awful. Reanimate it. Yeah, obviously attack here doesn't matter. I'm just considering whether to play a Clot Sliver or not. I think I do. Makes Vampire Hounds much worse, though. Just playing out our random threats like this. So hopefully he doesn't play anything to interfere with this Dothy Horror. Kind of just want that to go the full distance. While neither of us play any other cards. Whoa, such attacks. Take 2 down to 13. We'll attack him for 2 down to 16. I guess when he activates the stones, we're going to have to trade off the warrior for it, the serpent warrior. I just kindles it now, sure. So many serpent warriors. I don't really want to take 6. We could, though. Wish we had another mana to work with. We could even take 9 down to 4. That sounds really bad. This is actually worse, isn't it? Yeah, it's worse. Than just casting the other warrior from our hand. I was worried about regenerating with Clot Sliver. But if we just cast the warrior from our hand, we take 3 less damage. So we could just take one of these things hitting us. I guess this way it saves creatures in our hand, though. So that's kind of nice. For if we draw vampire hounds. Creatures in hand may be worth a little bit more than creatures in the graveyard. But both are pretty good. Take 1, drop to 6. That +3/+3 card could be really good here. Put it on the Dothy Horde and down to 11. Now the mana's not really ideal. We don't really get to do anything with it. I can't cast the Serpent Warrior and just die to 3 attacks from an Armored Pegasus. Not an option. I'm not sure why he didn't activate the Stalking Stones. Because it can pay for its own activation cost. Just kind of sitting over there. Bowling Giant, sure. Well, that's pretty good. So we got him down to 12. What could win this game? This deck needs like a Drain Life or a Second Shade or something. Just a little something. I might morph into a green-black deck after this game. So I don't have to play cards like Clot Sliver. The Spike Feeders seem like they could be good with these Shadow guys. Like, we have some green pump spells that could be really good at shortening the clock. And the life gain would work really well with, like, the reanimate and stuff as well. Yep, drop to 4. Why not? He could have animated the stones here and served with everything. Ugh. Yeah, I don't think we can win any kind of a race if he's playing Staunch Defenders. So what was I talking about? I was talking about adding green. What about a cut? Spinal Graft. Clot Sliver. These Dark Rituals. Maybe Justice, I'm not sure yet. Telethopter. Which has been okay, I guess. Shave one of the Serpent Warriors. Just be a little bit less painful. Keep all that nonsense. Bring in stuff that's hard to block. And then it's possible we want Rampant Growth with this new build. Not feeling the justice in this matchup. Or the Cursed Flesh. What kind of a mana base do we want here? So this would be 8 green sources. I think 8's enough. What would suggest something slightly different? And then is the Ramping Growth worth playing? Because getting from 1 green to 2 green is pretty important. Yeah, I think we're gonna run it. We kind of have to cut a spell for it. Maybe a reanimate. Even though the reanimates got a little bit better with adding these spike feeders. Oh, we could maybe cut the Revenant. How many creatures do we have? 15? Yeah, we're at one more creature than we used to be. Revenant hasn't been amazing. Yeah, we'll keep giving it a shot. Keep. Yeah, our mana looks really good with this hand. What are we looking for? We're looking for removal. Removal, more bodies, that sort of thing. Should have actually played a forest here, just in case we drew Spike Feeder and wanted to play it on turn 3. I'm guessing that we're going to want a Serpent Warrior on 3, pretty much regardless of what our opponent plays, though, so I don't think it's going to matter. I was also... When I played the second swamp, my thought process was that it would hide the fact that we boarded into green a little bit. But I don't think that's a big deal. Coffin Queen, that could be interesting. Serpent Warrior gets the most awkward creature to get pacifism to ward. Two serpent warriors, two reanimates, and justice is a lot. I'll admit that. I'm not too proud. Barbed Sliver, sure. Smithers, release the hounds. I want to attack with this thing. I kind of do. Form down to 15. And now he can attack back. But he can't get too aggressive. We can always trade his Wildcat for a random card in our hand. Probably the redundant Vampire Hounds. I mean, they're not really redundant. They're kind of cool to attack with. Considering just taking this trade, just trading one for one. Because if I discard, then he double pumps. But then we smack him for 4 again, down to 11. And play Coffin Queen. That's kind of good. Do I want to eat his whole turn doing that? Because the Wildcat didn't attack, so clearly he wants to play something. Is that what that means? I'm not sure if that's what that means. What if he had that white trick that just redirected damage? That'd be pretty brutal. Balls in your court, mate. I don't think I would make this play if I didn't have a Coffin Queen in my hand and, like, more pressure in play. It's Kindling in response. Alright, well, I guess I'm supposed to do this then. Didn't really want to discard Coffin Queen, but I think it's pretty good if he's kindling in response to try and get some kind of an advantage. Because he can't even pump to kill it now.
Yeah.
We have a lot of pretty solid draws. He plays a 1-2. We draw Reanimate. Reanimate's pretty good here. Do we mind trading the Hounds for his... I don't think we mind. I would snap make that block if I was him. There's no way you can just eat all this damage. Wow. Okay. Sure. We're still going to reanimate the Coffin Queen. And pass the turn. We're gonna make Coffin Queen back, Serpent Warrior, just take all the damage. I can do this as an instant, right? Yes, so I certainly can. He's at 12. No blocks. We could discard Shade Pump. That doesn't seem worth. We can always make that play at some other time. Although, if we discard Shade to pump, then activate Coffin Queen to put it into play, we could pump the three necessary to trade it with his worm. That's pretty good. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. Might be worse than just casting the Shade, but it's way more efficient. Just triple checking to make sure I can do this as an instant. Yeah, and he already burned a Kindle this game, so the odds that he can just get rid of a Coffin Queen really easily are kind of limited. And we still have some pretty bomby draws. Like if he kills the Queen, Revenant's a 4-4. Any shadow creature pumps our current shadow guy up to a 2x, and then we'd have two 2x shadow creatures attacking. The return two creature cards from our graveyard to our hand. Yeah, that card is actually really impressive. We've had a 4-mana version of that card in recent standard or in recent limited formats, but recent format limited formats are a little bit faster, so you have a little bit less time to dick around with getting two creatures back. And then they didn't have, like, gratuitous combos with the card either, these Vampire Hounds. The card is really good with Vampire Hounds. You could build a deck that's like 12 Vampire Hounds, 12 of that card, and just murder everybody. I would like to get back my Shade. Does that resolve? I would like to block with my Shade. Oh my god, I get to block. This is insane. Oh, he has to pass me priority in between each pump. I guess I could hold priority. It seems worse, though. Bandage. Prevent the next one damage that would be dealt. Sure, man. Let's decycle his bandage. Bandage isn't the worst card. I've seen that card get played in Legacy, actually. as a way for control decks to stop a Goblin Lackey hit. May untap permanents. Yes, I would like to untap my Coffin Queen. Oh, now it exiles it. It's going to remember it from the graveyard. Oh, no, it's not going to remember it from the graveyard. That's kind of lame, because it's not in play to exile, I guess. We're going to make the same attack we did last turn. And it's looking as though just untapping and killing him with a shade was a perfectly valid line that I did not take. Mauler, sure. Yeah, he can't attack with his worm. Yeah, apparently we should have just untapped and killed him. I thought I was taking the conservative line. I guess I was, but... Oh, Edict is real good. So it looks like we're going to a game three here. Unless his last card in hand and one open red mana is very good. Yeah, that was the wrong creature to sack. The game has ended. Yeah, he needed to sack this. And then trade his Wyvern for the Dungeon Shade. And go down to one, I guess. I guess that's a line. I mean, I would just concede. So, I guess it doesn't really matter. Yeah, this green-black version seems a little bit better. Did we play any cards that were green, though? I don't think we did. We drew a Rampant Growth that we didn't want to cast. That would be better as like a creature. I think it's just a matter of drawing our good cards. Like, in that game, we drew Vampire Hounds and Dungeon Shade. And if we draw those cards, the deck looks really good. And if we're, like, activating Coffin Queen, like, our deck's really good. But if we're drawing, like, Dark Rituals and Edicts and random Shadow Guys, the deck looks really suboptimal. Reanimates and Serpent Warriors, just a pile of those. But the Hounds, man, the Hounds. Yeah, I kind of like this, because even if I don't have the double green for, like, spike feeders and whatnot, we can just discard those creatures to the Hounds anyway. Maybe that means I shouldn't be running the Rampant Growth. Rampant Growth could maybe be something else. It looks pretty bad in this hand, right? Like, any actual card would probably be better than this. I guess we'll see how things play out. Getting extra swamps isn't the worst thing. Because we do have the Shade, which is a sink for them. Ooh, this could be really good. Just turn 2 Dothy Horror, turn 3 Pump It. Master Decoy, probably not running that line now. Though maybe, who knows? Solid attack. Gonna play a Snake Warrior, I guess. One of my first decks actually had a Standing Troops in it. It was not a very good deck. I think it had like over 100 cards. Way back in the day. The kitchen tablest of kitchen tables. I think I'm going to split up the Elven Rite, even though it leaves the horror a little weak to that shock he's playing. It just makes the Serpent Warrior a lot better on defense. Lets it attack through Standing Troops, if that's a thing that we want to do. It almost is. But not quite. Meanwhile, this ramping growth looks pretty miserable in our deck. Like, what are we ramping into? Spike Peter. I guess we have a Hulk in here. So I don't like attacking with the Serpent Warrior here, because then he can double block with these guys, and then we're trading the Serpent Warrior for his Furnace Brood. And right now the Serpent Warrior is like kind of holding them both back. Yeah, that's kind of what I was afraid of, is a Kindle on our evasive guy. But now we can get it back with the Coffin Queen, so we baited out the burn spell. That's kind of nice. Please no pacifism. Please no pacifism. Oh, he's just tapping it, sure. Ye old decoy. Take 4 damage, hits us to 12. Yeah, we need to draw like a Dark Vanishing or something pretty soon here. We do get to attack, which is kind of nice. Yeah, the reason I didn't... I already went over why I didn't attack last turn. Oh, this looks like a bandage to me. Oh, this is the worst. Splitting up that Elvish Rite has been awful for multiple reasons. Oh, this is way worse than a bandage. This is a smite. Yeah, I don't think we can win this game. Take another 4, drop down to 8. And then we're kind of just a little far behind to get back into this game. We didn't really do ourselves any favors by playing the Rampant Growth, but it is kind of just a matter of him playing a few more cards that were relevant than us. Like I said, it seemed like this deck had only a few cards that actually mattered, and they were the Vampire Hounds and the Shade. And in games where we didn't draw them, we had a real rough time, and in games where we drew them, it was pretty easy to win. And that was pretty consistent throughout the draft. Right now, he can hit us for 5. Oh, he can tap our blocker too. Yeah, he can just kill us. Magic! But it was kind of a cool draft. I think I learned some things about the format, even though the deck didn't perform particularly well, and we still had some sweet games in there, so... Yeah. I don't think I'm going to do too many of these for Channel Fireball, because I think other people might do them, and people probably only have limited interest in this incredibly old-school format. But I had a lot of fun making the video, and I've had a lot of fun drafting it on Modo, so I'm going to do more of that later. So yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next week, probably with some constructed video or other.